Good day and welcome to a new video.
Don't forget to like, share, subscribe.
Welcome in today. Today, welcome to the stream. I'm doing a 90-minute art challenge. As I've been doing the last few weeks, some more successful than others, some less successful and things like that. You know how things go with these challenges when you got like a time frame in mind, when you got things, other things to do as well, but also, you know, trying to get stuff done within that 90 minutes of this this painting that I'm doing. It's fun challenges, fun times. It's the fourth one in fourth one, I think, in a row since this week, in the past few weeks. I have done a few backgrounds. I did an animal one where I did a squirrel, had some fun with that. I think it was last week I talked about that one. This week I've got a Nathan Fowkes drawing. I'm pretty sure it's Nathan Fowkes drawing that I've got going on. Yeah. The Nathan Fowkes drawing that I am painting, basically one of his, and he's an awesome artist that has worked on the likes of Rio, and he's been like on Bobby Chio's channel a few times. He's got his own YouTube stuff going on. He's got a class on schoolism as well, which is really cool. And yeah, he's really kind of, in a way, a king with kind of colour, and in my mind, he is really kind of a king of colour in a way, because he really knows how to use colour. So, you know, doing this painting, doing this study, is kind of something that I've wanted to do. You know, I've wanted to study a few artists out there, so doing a few of their paintings and understanding the way they do things and things like that. So doing this painting has given me the opportunity to do that, because I've only spent like 90 minutes to understand the way he's painted it and perceived his painting here, basically. And, you know, I had lots of fun. I was playing around with changing up the way I do things a little bit for this painting. You know, usually I just do a standard rounded brush and just kind of draw it and paint it up, and might do a tonal study and things like that. But here I'm trying a new brush. I'm still going the same kind of tonal method where I kind of go for the tones first and understand those first. I'm still kind of, you know, using some of the things I know here. But, you know, I try new things. You know, I tried a new texture brush. I found an interesting new brush to try. I think it's a watercolor brush or something like that. So I usually don't use texture brushes, but I decided for this one, you know, because here's an interesting way of doing this. He does use, as far as I know, Nathan Fowkes does use like texture brushes and things like that. So I thought, why not trial something new, give it a go. It's always good to do that. And you know, a few interesting comments from these 90-minute art challenges, offering me, you know, some advice and things like that, which has been awesome seeing you guys talk about these videos and some of the artworks I'm creating. For me, these 90-minute art challenges aren't exactly, you know, portfolio pieces. You know, they're not pieces I stick in my portfolio. And I think it's good to do them that way. It's kind of good to just have something there that's not kind of, oh, look at me, I did this pretty picture, or something like that. There's something that you can learn from, and, you know, if someone points out that this looks, you know, not so great and things like that, you're not so worried about it. I mean, even in my personal stuff, I know some of that kind of stuff is not the best it could be, I guess, because, you know, the level I was at back then, it probably was, or the amount of skill and knowledge I had back then, it probably was the best that I could do at the time. In time, maybe that could be a thing, you know, with it, the time I had to produce the piece and things like that. But also, yeah, the skills and new things that I've learnt could add something to it. So, you know, it's always good to just have a little bit of fun, bit of play around, and keep learning new things and trying these new things. So this was a good opportunity to learn from other artists and what they do, their approach, and yeah, in a way, how I would do it as well if I was to paint it, I guess. Kind of seen that kind of approach to it. I mean, I haven't seen much of Nathan Fowkes actually painting himself, as far as I know. I've seen a few here and there, but not like very closely of how they paint and know their techniques and everything like that, how they work, you know, whether they draw the thing. I've seen some of his like quick painting stuff that he's done, and playing around with colors and things like that. I know one of the artists I was watching and things like that, they were doing like thumbnails, just playing around with color and color compositions and things like that. I don't want to say it's Nathan Fowkes, I think it is, but you know, they were just playing around with little thumbnails. You know, thumbnails will only take maybe 2 minutes each to do, you know, to do a little bit of colouring and a little bit of thing, because the thumbnails are really, really small, but you can, with that small thumbnail, you can really see if an image is going to work in that small, and that's kind of the things he does before he goes into this kind of stage. Yeah, so that could have been good too, is doing like a little composition. Another way you can do it is like really just zoom out of the image and just kind of do those small patches and things like that to help you out. So I think that's one thing that I could have tried as well, and I'll be keen to try it in another 90 minute art challenges. This, you know, because I don't have that kind of, I guess, pressure, you know, to be like, this is an image that I'm creating that has to look really good because it's for such and such. You know, if you're taking away that pressure, definitely it gets you the freedom to grow and trial new things. And, you know, I haven't had as much of that over the last probably a couple of years at least. You know, I haven't had as much of that. I have every now and again, you know, done a few of these 90-minute challenges over the last, you know, 4 or 5 months. I have done a few, you know, art challenges and random paintings and drawings that I've played around. I've done, also, I do kind of daily sketches that I draw something every day. So I've had, you know, I have had fun in learning and playing around, and but not as much as these 90-minute art challenges, because it's, you know, it's doing a full painting within that 90-minute art challenge, and it's great. One thing, you know, learning from mistakes. I think last week was quite bad. Last week, you know, I had to, I think it was halfway through, I started to get like a really dry throat. So I needed a glass of water. I had to, you know, signal my partner to get me some water. And, that was quite funny. But you know, I learned from that, and now with every stream, I make sure there's going to be a glass of water there, so that you know, if I do, do start to kind of get croaky or start to get sore throat or something like that, I can have some water. Because, you know, talking for 40 minutes, constantly, you know, I'm doing this like once a week, plus, you know, Tuesday, I'm chatting a bit, just a fair bit of, a little bit of chatting there, so, you know, you can experience those things and, you know, have in the past, and it just comes from experience, obviously, just knowing those things, looking after my health and those kind of things. So yeah, making sure I have a glass of water. I've got also myself some like Strepsil things, like throaties. They are basically, and you know, have had a kind of a sore throat, coldy thing. And I had those throaties over the last 4 or 5 days. I've had less than the last 2 days anyway, like one a day or something. But 2 days, like the start of this week, like Tuesday, Wednesday or something, it was quite bad, and then it got better during the week. And you know, I'm not always on them, but you know, I would have them every now and again, and that's always, that has actually helped me. I think it's it got much better. If I didn't have them, I think by now doing the stream, I'd still be a bit croaky, it'd still be pretty bad. So yeah, just taking care of your health and getting those things that you need is always good. As well as, you know, when you're doing art and even these 90-minute art challenges, getting things you need, whether you need to take a breather for it. You know, not everyone's the same doing. Some people can sit down for 90 minutes and do one of these challenge, no sweat, you know, no problems, have a really good painting at the end, you know, no teething problems. It might be because they have a subject they really understand and draw all the time or something like that. But yeah, and they're used to it and those kind of things. But for me, it is, you know, challenging. I'm used to kind of, in a way, going at my own pace, you know, taking breaks and, you know, stretching it out a little bit, you know, not so in your face 90 minutes of painting. And it's been challenging, you know, doing these 90 minute art challenges. I've really got to start pretty much as soon as the computer's kind of on and I've got everything set up, I've got to start, because you know, if I don't start, usually I like to finish about 10 at night is when I'm finished all my painting and everything I need to do for the night. And if I don't kind of kick off gear and keep going, keep painting for that 90 minutes, if I have too many breaks, by the time I finish, it's about 10:15, 10:20, and I started, you know, 8:15, and I haven't finished till like, you know, 10:15, so it's like 2 hours, so an extra half hour to do a 90-minute art challenge, if, you know, if I take the breaks. But, you know, sometimes I do need it. There's certain things, like, especially, like, for instance, this painting, I had to go out and get a new brush for Photoshop, so I got a new watercolor brush to trial out, because none of the brushes that I had, I was kind of too happy with using for this painting, just because it's too textural for me to use, so I went for something a little bit less textural. Also, the brush shape was a little bit interesting to paint with as well. You know, I'm used to painting or drawing with a circle brush, so drawing with something that looks a little bit different is another aspect too, to it. You know, you're drawing with a different shape. So, you know, you trial those things out. And you know, try these things out. I guess that you kind of you can get into that state where you work on things and you work on things, and that's your way of doing things, you know. But so you go for that kind of safe zone, you know, that where comfort zone, where this is 90-minute challenge is kind of still in your comfort zone, but it's a little bit out of it, so that you can trial new things in a safe environment in a way, you know. You don't have to worry because it's a 90-minute challenge. I mean, there's all you guys watching on, say, either Twitch or YouTube, seeing these paintings and what I'm doing. And probably judging me for it or something like that, but I'm not so worried because I'm not like posting on social media, I'm not like anything like that. That this isn't my portfolio or something like that, or the highlight of my work or anything like that. So I'm not so worried. Yeah. Awesome. Yeah. As I said, I do stream these on Twitch and then they get exported to YouTube. After, usually the day after, the morning after, or something like that. Lately I've been doing my 90-minute art challenges, so Wednesday or Thursday, and then I'm streaming with that 90-minute art challenge on the Friday or Saturday. It all depends, what's going on that weekend and everything else. Awesome. I do stream them and everything like that. So if you are interested in watching me live, I do have a Tuesday stream that you can come check out every Tuesday at NZD time. Tuesday at roughly usually 8:15. That's usually when I start streaming on Tuesday. Around that time, 8:30-ish, 8:15, 8:30 p.m. NZD time on a Tuesday, usually, and then Friday and Saturday, one of those 2 days at night time. But if you subscribe to my Twitch, subscribe to my YouTube, you see these. You don't see my Tuesday streams, but you see the weekend streams going there. Awesome, thank you. As I said, I'm creating. Or I'm recreating a Nathan Fowkes drawing, painting, sorry, a Nathan Fowkes painting. I'm giving it kind of my best shot, trying to achieve what he's achieved in this painting. He's looks like he got like it's kind of like concept art in a way, which it's quite loose and. Not so, I guess, illustrational, and that's kind of good for me to have that though, to have a little bit doing a painting that's more loose, because I think I'm super tight with the things I draw and paint, and having that looseness or practicing that looseness is something I wanted to improve on, show so I can show like the depth of field and improve on those skills. So this definitely was a challenge for me, go kind of against my odds and against my favor, but I did the best I could and I felt like I got a bit out of it and that's what's important. But Yeah, awesome. Yeah, I recommend 90-minute art challenges, because like I was saying before, they do let you kind of let everything go. You don't have to worry about producing a great piece because you don't exactly have to show anyone. You don't have to show anyone your 90-minute art challenges. I do here because it's the only thing I've got to stream with at the moment. And it's fun for you to see this, I guess. See me paint, see me fail, and see me succeed, and all that stuff. you know, and show you guys what's like to do these 90-minute art challenges. Because, yeah, you get to trial new things. I trial different brushes, trialing to get, you know, the tones right as well, to try new things to get my tones in the right place. And also with that, with tones, I decided in one of the other paintings that I moved too quickly to colour, you know. And I decided for this painting, I was going to hold it off, that colour, till at least halfway, you know. I was going to slowly switch over rather than, you know, within the first 20-ish minutes, I was slowly adding colour. You know, so it was like, okay, well, let's push it so that I'm working on tone a lot more. And, you know, you saw me there, I added colour, very kind of in there, just vaguely though, like I splashed the colour in there, and then I went back to tone, you know. I was like, nah, I'm going back to tone. So yeah, I do this all in Photoshop. I enjoy Photoshop, and it's just something I've been using for years. I've had no issues, apart from a few teething problems every now and again. And, you know, the main reason for me that I do use it is because I can do a lot with it. I have, you know, that has the text tool in it, that I can use text if I need to use it. It has some editing tools if I need to edit a few things. It's animation tools. There's awesome tools in there. But yeah, text tool is really important for me, because with my children's book, I've got to edit text and place text. It's the same with creating my thumbnails for YouTube. I've got to create text and use text freely, where other drawing programs for me and creating programs for me don't have good text tools usually. And, you know, I was with Photoshop, it's probably when it started, the text tool was really bad, you know. It was, every time I use it, you do a sentence and the second line of that sentence or something like that would be back to front. When you type it, it'll be like, I don't know, some random sentence like, I am a fish, you know, and the first thing on the line would say I am, and then the next line would be fish backwards. And that used to annoy me, like totally annoy me. And that's why I didn't like it. I used to use Adobe had other products like InDesign. I used to use InDesign for my text. But when I moved to my new computer, I couldn't bring over my old InDesign programs. So I have to get the Photoshop. And that's the thing, it's not free for Photoshop. You cheapest option is the photography plan for it. So you have to pay for it, basically. That's the other kind of downfall with Photoshop and other programs. Some programs you can buy for a couple of $100, or less, you know. Some are only like $30, or, you know, but each has their up and downs, you know. Photoshop's not too expensive, but, you know, it's not free. So, but for me, it's worth it. I need the text. I enjoy Photoshop. It's worth it. It's my fun. It's kind of my joy. I could use another program, but then I'd had the problem of being able to use text, and that problem to solve on top of it. Which is something I could solve. I could buy another program that could do that thing for me. But yes, again, I've got to fork out to buy that program. So for me, Photoshop Is the way to go at the moment. Things could change, and this thing, you don't want to get too stuck to a program, I guess. But if it works for you, it works for you. There's nothing wrong with whatever works for you. With my editing for videos, I use HitFilm, and it's really good. You can get it for free. You can get the pro version if you like, which is, I'm pretty sure with a pro version, you just pay what you like. I think there's a certain amount of fees that you have to pay, but you can get the pro version, what lets you do quite a little bit more. But for me, I'm not very, I don't need all those pro features, like I don't exporting and importing like 3D models and all those things that you can do within Pro. I don't need those features, so it's a good free program, HitFilm, if you're editing videos. All I need it for is basically speeding up. I used to be able to do it on Windows Movie Maker, and that's gone. I think there's a video editor, and that's about it. And it can't do what I want. Video editor on Microsoft now is just pretty much piecing. You can only kind of piece videos together and then export it. You can't kind of speed them up or anything like that. As far as I know. But yeah, it's simple video editor. I use that too, but that's just for exporting the little short clips. But yeah, those are programs I use. And yeah, Photoshop. I do have the other programs that are free, like Sketchbook Pro. No, just Sketchbook, isn't it? Just Sketchbook. I do have Sketchbook. Haven't used it in a long, long time. But it's there, and also, to use it, you do have to log in. But I'm pretty sure Sketchbook's free. You just need to log in, basically, to it. Which is like, oh, you have to log in. But yeah, also with Adobe, I do get Lightroom as well. Yeah, Sketchbook is really cool to use. It has some cool features that at first, I think, well, I didn't notice that Photoshop actually had those features. It's the butterfly tool, and I didn't notice that. Might have been a couple of years ago that Photoshop that got the butterfly tool, which I found really, really cool. And it's a really cool interface to use Sketchbook as well. It's a great drawing app to use. And it's, yeah, I would use it every now and again if I want to, but for me, yeah, I'm used to it, so I just use it. But yeah. Awesome. Yeah. So, yeah, this 90-minute challenge I've been, now I've kind of introduced color and, probably just over half away there. Yeah, more than just over half. So I've kind of slowly kind of introduced color towards the end. Which I felt worked way better, and that's what I'm going to keep on doing. I'm going to keep on doing that. That I'm going to definitely stay in the tonal side of things, much longer than I'm used to. And that's one, I think, one good thing that's coming out of this, to doing these 90-minute art challenge. I'm starting to loosen back a little bit on wanting to add color, so that's good. As well as trying new things, trying new brushes, and playing around and having some fun here and there. And I think it's worked for the best for this piece. I felt like I've done some things good here, but I've done some things. But it is a challenge. It's 90 minutes. I haven't had 3 weeks to finish it off, and but it doesn't really matter too much. I've gone out of this piece. I could try again, like I want to do with some of the other pieces that I want to do. But I'm gonna take what I can from all these paintings that I do, these 9 minute art challenges, and bring it into my future endeavors. That's what's important. I'm taking something out of it, and that's, it's always kind of important. That's why these challenges are very helpful. They only take 90 minutes. Like, if you are kind of a full-time learner at home, got all the time in your hands, you could actually sit there and do three or four of these challenges a day. I don't have the luxury of that time, so I can only do about one or two a week. But yeah, you could really do a few of these art challenges. Or, if you don't want to tire yourself too much out, you could, do one of these challenges and then work on your main things. I think it's good to do that if you're working on your main things, and then at night you're closing up, so you're doing that 90-minute art challenges, or in the morning the other way, you do your 90-minute art challenges to warm up, and then you continue your day normally. That could be interesting. In the little bit of the future, I'm definitely looking at trying to work something like these in. Maybe it could be drawing or sketching within maybe 45 minutes or half an hour, that I could do like quickly in the morning or something like that. But we'll, I definitely, someone on the stream here on the Twitch stream was saying, just shout out to you guys. You try to draw something every day, even if it's just doodling. That's always good to keep yourself alive. I try to draw something every day as well. For a few years I was doing like a daily sketch that I'll kind of post on DeviantArt. I did that for a long time, and then I slowly kind of gave up on that because I had other things that were more important on working on rather than working on that daily sketch. And other things that came up, like I tried the Inktober challenges, and I've done that for about 4 or 5 years now, doing the Inktober challenges where you draw an ink drawing every day. And yeah, I've done so much of that kind of thing. For me, the thing I believe it's kind of putting in the effort. It's not about, oh, I did so many drawings. I did one drawing today, two drawings yesterday. It's, yeah, the effort that you put in, and that's coming out more every day now. That it's definitely about, the effort I'm putting in. The time as well, how much time I actually put in, but I feel, I can only put so much time in. I only put as much time in as I can, and when things come up, and I feel other things are a little bit more important, if I, spending time with the family and doing other things around the house, like cleaning up and dishes, and some of these things that come up, if I do feel like they're a little bit important, At that time, I do take my break and just, you know, there's only so much time at sea. It's when I do have the time, it's putting in that effort when I do have the time, basically. Yeah, Inktober can be really easy for some people because, you know, they're already kind of doing that. It just gives them a little bit more of a focus. It's like you know, they know what to do, they know what they're doing. And for some people, really exhausting because it's like fighting an uphill battle. Because you're not used to the kind of daily routines of you have to do this every day and you have to, you know, and exhausting for some people because, you know, you give it your all at the start, you're trying to produce the best work you can from it, and then you just run yourself out within the first couple of days. And you don't have anything to keep going on because it's like, oh, you produce, you know, two or three good pieces, and then, you know, you start to slow down, and you've kind of, you know, run the marathon at the start, and you ran out of energy halfway and fallen on the ground, fallen asleep or something, you know. So you just gotta kind of slowly pace it. Don't put all your efforts in, kind of at the start. Just, you know, steadily just do it. It's just a daily routine thing. You know, you can obviously, for me, Inktober wasn't a, that's it, that's what I'm doing for the month. I'm just doing the Inktobers and that's it. You know, I had a lot going on in that month. And for lots of people, that can be the thing that blows them off Inktober. They're doing a lot of other stuff. But for me, I'm good at that kind of thing where, you know, this is my routine. I'm good at routines where I can add something in or take something away. It's not just so bad, you know. It's I can keep up with it every day. You know, if I have to do, say, the dishes in the morning, I do dishes in the morning. That becomes part of my routine. It's like when you get a job or something like that, and maybe you might need to make lunch for yourself or have breakfast at a certain time. You know, you get into that routine of I know how to do this. I have breakfast, make my lunch, and go out the door. You know, you get into that routine. You know what you're doing. Same with Inktober. You get your pens out. You get your paper out. You get your pad. Just making those things accessible, really accessible. All over your desk, having ink all over the table and then accidentally spilling it. But you know, having ink out, or if you don't want to go traditional ink, you can do pen ink. I did pen ink because that's easier. Whip it out of my bag, really easy. I didn't have to worry about kind of sharpening my bamboo stick, or you know, I didn't have to worry about all that stuff. I just, you know, pull the pen out of my bag and start inking it. So making it accessible as well, you know, takes away that pressure. And you know, I'm really good at finding those routines. Exactly for keeping up with my YouTube channel. I know what I need to produce for these YouTube videos, and I know how long roughly it takes me to do the weekly tips and how to prepare for them, what kind of helps to prepare for them, for my, say, my weekly tips that I do. To prepare for them, I have to find the reference. And then I have to have another drawing file that I draw in, and my reference all placed out, and a grey background to draw on. You know, if I have all those things set up for me, that I can, you know, once it's all set, I'm off. You know, I can do my 90-minute art challenge really quite easily, no struggles. Well, 90-minute art. Same with 90-minute art challenge. You know, I've got my image, I've got my drawing file that I'm drawing with already all set. That means when I do have it to go, boom, I'm ready. I'm off. I'm doing this 90-minute art challenge, and you know, I get done. So having those things prepared does help. You know, yeah. So yeah, I know kind of the routines and trying to keep. I guess you have to trial it, you know, with the Inktober. You kind of go into it, you don't know what to expect. And you know, then you start the 3 days, you're like, oh, that's not for me. But just, you know, working out good habits within that month would be good. Like, you know, the first few days went well or something. Why did the next one go badly? Why did you give up that day? Is it had no ideas, or well, where did you get your first three ideas from? You know, maybe you only had like three ideas. Well, how do you create more ideas? Maybe you need to, you know, take maybe the first three ideas, and maybe just for the fourth day, just make an iteration of one of the first good ideas you have, just to get by, and then the next day, trial something new. You know, don't just, you know, give up. There's another thing with it, you know, with those challenges, just don't give up. The same with these 90-minute challenges. Things didn't work out, and some things didn't go so great, and I didn't give up on it though. I still trial to try and make, say, these leafs look like, you know, what they look like in Nathan Fowkes' drawing. Those elephants, I try to make them look like the elephants that were in the painting that he did. I still feel like there's room for improvement, and you know, it does look a bit scratchy, my line. For my, you know, me looking at it, I feel it looks a bit scratchy. But yeah, you know. That's been me doing my 90-minute art challenge. So hopefully you did enjoy this video and did learn something from it. I had real fun doing this 90-minute art challenge, and great presenting it to you and just talking about my experience with it. So let me know down in the comments what you thought about this painting that I did. Maybe what you thought about if you did this challenge, or if you will be doing this challenge, you know, what your thoughts are on that. You know, I have fun doing these, fun growing and trying to learn new things. At the moment, I really try to push myself and try to, you know, grow with you guys, as well as just growing as us in general. So hopefully you enjoy seeing, you know, me grow and me produce interesting new pieces. Keep drawing, everyone. Keep creating, and see you in the next video.